Hello and welcome to this video lecture series on digital communication. In this video, we are going to discuss MSK. MSK is minimum shift key. We have already discussed about QPSK. So in QPSK, what we did, we took the digital data, we divided it into even and odd parts, and the even data was sent using sign carrier, the odd data was sent using cause carrier. So this is how we had the phase quadrature between the two carriers, and this is how the bandwidth was efficient. Bandwidth was saved and the bandwidth became more efficient. So now why MSK? In MSK, the phase don't vary like that. In the QPSK, the phase vary by the phase quadrature, which is 90 degree. So the cause and sign has the phase quadrature. But in MSK, the phase varies smoothly, not abruptly. And in the second case, the bandpass filters are not required because in MSK, we have smaller side lobes and thinner main lobe. So in QPSK, the main lobe was more thick, but in MSK the main lobe is thin. So we'll see these things in the advantages of MSK. So like all the videos, we'll start with the waveforms, and after that we'll see the mathematical part, then transmitter, receiver, advantages, disadvantages, and we'll also discuss the constellation diagram and bandwidth. So there you'll see the bandwidth is more for MSK. So let's begin with the waveform. So we'll take an example. So first we'll draw the unipolar NRZ line encoding of the given data. So in unipolar NRZ, 1 is represented by plus V and 0 is represented by 0. So now I'll make the polar NRZ representation. In polar NRZ, 1 is represented by plus V and 0 is represented by minus V. So after that, I'll divide it into B odd T and B even T. So we'll divide our data in odd data and even data. So odd data is the data which is present at the odd place, and even data is present at the even place. So this is my first place, second place, third. So odd data is all the data which is present at the odd place. So I am circling the odd data. Now when I have to draw the even data would start from the even position. So if I have to draw the even data, it will start from the second position. So even data is all the data which is not circled. So the first data is 0, which is made for 2-bit position, after that 1. So the first data is 0, which is made for 2-bit position, after that 1, 0, 0. 1 for 2-bit position, after that 0 and again 0. So this is how I'll make the odd data and even data. Now I'll make so black is representing cos omega bt by 4 and green is representing sin omega bt by 4. So sin is starting from 0 and cos is starting from 1. So now I'll multiply the odd data with cos omega bt and I'll multiply the even data with sin omega t, omega bt by 4. So the odd data is having the magnitude plus v at plus 1 and minus v at 0. So whenever I have transition from plus v to minus v, the odd data when multiplied by cos omega t, so the transition would change the phase in the 180 degree. So how the phase is changing from 0 to 180 degree, for that you can see my previous video on BPSK. So when 1 is multiplied by cos omega t, I'll get cos omega t. But when minus 1 is multiplied by cos omega t, I'll get minus cos omega t, which can be represented as minus cos omega t plus pi. So this is how I'll get the pi phase difference when I change my data from 1 to 0. So I hope now you understand how my data would change. So now my B or T start from here So I'll make the cos omega t. And here at this bit duration, it has 180 degree phase shift. So again at this bit duration, here again I'll have 180 degree phase shift. So this is how I'll represent B.T multiply cos omega t by 4. Now I'll multiply B even t by sin omega t by 4. So again, when I have the transition, the phase would change by 180 degree. So here I'll start. Here I have 180 degree phase reversal. Again 180 degree phase reversal. And then the data is going. So now after that, I'll make a high frequency carrier. Now I'll make a low frequency carrier. So after that, I'll see the bits of odd data and even data. Now the odd data here is 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Even data is 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So now I'll combine the two bits and I'll write it down. So here it is 1, 0, here it is 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So wherever I have same bits, so here I have one bit which is 1 and another bit is 0. So it is represented by low frequency carrier. Whenever I have, so again it has 1, 1 and 1, 0, so different bits which are represented by low frequency carrier. When I have same bits, it is represented by high frequency carrier. Similarly, here I'll have low frequency carrier. Here I'll have high frequency carrier. Then low frequency, low frequency. So these are the various waveforms which will originate in this MSK. So I hope now you understood various things which are happening. So according to the waveform, we'll find the block diagram of the transmitter. So we have a high frequency carrier and a low frequency carrier. We'll multiply both and then we'll pass it through the band pass filter. So the band pass filter will select only the selected frequency and reject all the high and low frequencies. So the first band pass filter is of the frequency omega C plus omega B by 4, and the second band pass filter is of the frequency omega C minus omega B by 4. So from here I am getting the frequency omega C plus omega B by 4, and from here I am getting the frequency omega C minus omega B by 4, which is sent to the addition block. So here I will get the addition of the signal plus the signal which is getting from here. So here I will get the subtraction. After that, the upper part is multiplied by odd bits and the lower part is multiplied by the even bits, which are combined, and I'll get the output. So here ST is the output modulated signal. So now when I write down the mathematical representation of ST, so now I know a formula. So I know the formula 2 sin A cos B is equal to sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. 2 cos A sin B is equal to sin A plus B minus sin A minus B. So I'll represent this with the help of this formula. So here A is omega CT and B is omega BT by 4. A is omega CT, B is omega BT by 4. So now when I represented it like this, So now I'll take the sine omega CT plus omega BT by 4 common from here and from here. So after that I left out with So now it is under root 2ps b odd t plus b even t by 2 sin omega ct plus omega bt by 4 plus under root 2ps b odd t minus b even t by 2 sin omega ct minus omega bt by 4. So now I'll represent this full term with a variable c1 and this full term with c2. So again I can represent under root 2ps as under root PSTS into under root 2 by TS. So replacing it. Similarly here I'll replace it. So now this is my amplitude and this into this is my phi 1. Similarly this into this is my phi 2. Phi 1 and phi 2 are my orthonormal functions or the basis functions. So I can represent STS. So phi 1 is high frequency orthonormal function, phi 2 is low frequency orthonormal function. So when I have to represent them, I'll represent phi h, phi l, and when I have to make the signal space diagram, I'll project this on phi h. So here it is under root es, because under root psts is under root es, here it is under root es. So now Euclidean distance can be found out using the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse is represented by under root 2ES. So ES is 2EB. 2 into 2EB. So which means 2 under root EB. So the Euclidean distance is 2 under root EB. So I hope now you understood how the transmitter is working and the mathematical part behind the transmitter. So from here I am getting the high frequency component, from here the low frequency component. So from this equation I can see high frequency, low frequency added, high frequency, low frequency subtracted. So this part is happening here. So this is high frequency, this is low frequency. Here it is added, here it is subtracted. After that it is multiplied by odd and even bits respectively. So this is how various mathematical parameters are occurring at the transmitter of the MSK. So now we'll discuss the receiver. So this is the block diagram of the receiver. The output modulated signal is ST, which is multiplied by sin A cos B and cos A sin B. I hope you remember what is A and B. A was omega CT, B was omega BT by 4. So the signal is multiplied with sin A cos B and cos A sin B with the help of product modulator. After that it is passed to the low pass filter. So at the lower low pass filter it is integrated from 0 to 2k, and at the upper side it is integrated from 2k minus 1 to 2k plus 1 dt. After that it is fed to the decision making device, which gives the information that the received data is 1 or 0, and with the help of regenerator we can regenerate the signal. So now I hope you understand, with the help of the signal only I can generate the carriers. With the help of So now you can understand, in the receiver I am multiplying with the carrier. So this is my coherent type of receiver. In coherent type of receiver, with the help of these blocks I can generate the carrier itself. So with the help of square law device I can increase the power. So power is increased by a degree of 4 with the help of square law device. After that I'll pass it through band pass filter of the level 4f. And after that I'll divide it with the frequency divider with the value 4. So after that I'll get the carrier, high frequency carrier, which is converted with the help of 90 degree phase shift into the sine carrier as well, and I'll get sine and cos carrier both. So with the help of this circuit, I can regenerate the carriers. So this is how the receiver is working. The sine A cos B component is multiplied at the upper product modulator. Now low pass filter, decision making device. Similarly, cos A sine B multiplied the low pass filter, decision making device. I hope now you remember. In this would be the high frequency component, and with multiplication we'll get the cos square and sine square terms, which would become the high frequency signal, and it helps me rejecting the low frequency message signal from the modulated signal. So now the bandwidth. So the bandwidth is 0.5 FB. So now advantages. So the bandwidth is 1.5 FB. So the continuous phase change of carrier and low side lobes, which means band pass filter is not required. In the case of QPSK, we had abrupt phase change of 90 degree and the band pass filter was required because of high side lobes of PSD. So I'll stop at this point. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, share it with your friends and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.